What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back. It's been a tough day for me. I'm gonna say this off bat because I don't want you guys to think that I'm shortchanging you guys. There's a lot of episodes available. I know the channel is only at, like, I think episode 11 currently, and we're at episode like 15 or 16, but we're taking our time. I think I saw a comment today as I'm about to record this, a comment on episode 11 that said that this series is a slow burn. It's not as let me see if I can find a comment really quick, so I can give a little bit of shout out here. So the comment basically said that he feels like, this is from Mike J, feel like Nirvana in Fire 2 is more of a slow burn than part 1, right? Still good, but a bit difficult to stay focused. That was the gist of it, right? That was the gist of it. So I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that I agree. I agree that it is a slow burn. I never really thought of it like that. You know what I'm saying? Because I did realize that whenever I sit down to watch Nirvana in Fire 2, you know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes I can sit down and watch 2-3 episodes, and sometimes I can only watch one episode, and that's not because I'm constricted with time. I remember when I was watching Nirvana in Fire 1, like, there were days when I couldn't stop watching the show. Like, it's that good. You know what I'm saying? I think the most episodes I watched in one session of Nirvana in Fire, when I was watching it, I think it was like 10 or 11 episodes or some shit like that. Like, it was nuts how addictive the show is and how much I was enjoying that show. Not the same here for Nirvana in Fire 2, but that's not to say that the show is not great in its own respect. It's just not as bingeable. You get what I'm saying? Because the episodes, I don't know how to describe it. The episodes doesn't really, they take a lot of time to present what they're presenting. And to be honest, when it comes on to the characters in this show, they're not as compelling. You get what I'm saying? And it's not the actor's fault. I think it's the writing's fault. Even though the writing is saying, if I was supposed to compare it with Nirvana in Fire, I would say that the writing is a bit more, it's a little less. You get what I'm saying? So if Nirvana in Fire is a 10, I would put this at a 8.5, if you will, right? So that's the kind of experience that I'm having with it. So that's not to say that I'm not going to watch it till the end. I know a lot of people are suggesting so many different C-dramas. I know that maybe some people, it's not getting as much views as Nirvana in Fire, the first one, but I'm still going to finish the series because I want to see how this story ends no matter what. And then I will talk about it. Of course, I'm going to do a series finale. Series review, of course. So let's jump into episode 16 and I will see you guys at the end. To review.
This 事不怪大哥，都是我的错。大哥一直说全责有别，叫我不要插手的。当然是你的错，你想过没有？万一出什么事儿，我还有你大哥有多担心？还是知道有些冒险，但段同舟一向踪迹难寻。
好不容易看到一个机会，我以为你以为你有些小聪明，别人都是傻瓜，是不是？你这次算运气不错了，要不然，你大哥赶过去就只能给你。我听说你受伤了，伤在哪儿啊？
父王，没事，过两天就好了。
伤好了，自己去贵小祠堂。是。好了，事情过去了，今年的事情有惊无险，不必一直挂在心上。被淹使团的人已经到了，很多事情需要你去做呢。是，父王。
True. Yeah, he's I want you guys to tell me which one has the better soundtrack, part one or part two?
大统领，首府巡。
知道了，我知道他会来，请他进来吧。
是。
Is he ready to fess up?
就打听到了这些。
咱们的人，要么当场被杀了，要么已经被擒在押，一时见不到。当时段先生被围，在场的只有那几位高手，无人能靠近。究竟是什么情形，连咱们在巡防营的人都没打听清。师父知道，能追到段先生那边去的人都是大人物，徒儿哪敢多说一句话。
段腾州死前身边倒是有个人，可以去问一问。
我听说段腾州死了，是真的吗？
Nigga, I don't even want to talk to you right now. Why are you in my face? You don't even want to tell the truth.
不再做那样的事了吗？
飞展呐，你是不是以为昨天那一切都是我安排的呀？
和谈尚未达成，而马场却提前知道了机密消息，平静一出城便遭到了埋伏。叔父不会是想说，这一切纯属都是巧合而已吧？
我知道，你一直觉得所有这一切我最可疑。
Because you are suspicious.
叔父真的什么事情都没有做。
那段同舟呢？段同舟的出现你又怎么解释？
我不是跟你说过了吗？段同舟不是我手下的人呐。
What was he doing in your place？
我跟他没有任何来往，我怎么可能去指使他做任何事情呢？退一步说，就算他是我的人，可我怎么能让他去杀害萧平京呢？我与长林王府素有分歧，可那都是朝堂的政见，绝无私怨。我凭什么要去杀害一个孩子呢？飞展呢
？That's not the point. That's not the point.
段同舟为了不被我们生擒，是自己找机会跳下悬崖而死的。
啊？
那段同舟的幕后指使到底是谁？你真的连一点线索都没有吗？
大人放心，绝不会让您沾手。
这个叔父还真的想不到还有谁。
Bullface lies。
从我看到段同舟的那一刻起，我心里就明白，我是被故意引到那里。
萧侯爷可知道在下这么安排的用意啊？
是为了萧平章，对吗？
令堂生前曾经对世子妃下过手，这可是一个很难解的结。先要消除萧平章对你的厌恶。
是啊，在这位长林世子的眼中，恐怕再难有什么是比试图搭救萧平京更大的人情了。即便我没有丝毫耽搁地赶回去报信，从京城赶来援救也是来不及的。
可惜段同舟，我本有七八分的胜算，但是没有想到，
没有想到半路杀出个瀚海剑拓跋宇，萧平京逃得性命，而您最得力的段同舟反倒折了进去。
悄悄的告诉我京兆府尹，从明天起暗中监看前天院。
是大人。
段同舟的反应已经算是很快了，在我们赶到之前他就不想恋战，急着撤走。瀚海剑下想要脱身并不容易，等到巡飞斩一到，这山野之间哪里还能找得到生路啊？
我还是有些不解，拓跋宇乃是一国局外之人，何况 他怎么就会突然杀出来？那个时候，他应该踏踏实实的守在惠王殿下身边。
这确实是最大的一个变数。不过我听说，他之所以过去，也不算意外，是萧平京事先利用琅琊高手榜上的排名，把他引逗过去的。
江湖中人最在乎的，无非就是那点名誉。拓跋羽一旦确保惠王的安全之后，就奔着他的名誉而去了。
不管怎么说，在萧平章那里的人情，我总算是挣到了一点。
Which is what you wanted, right?
应该怎么办才算最好？
路要一步一步走，很多事情要到了眼前以后才知道如何应对。小侯爷现在应该做的，是要坚定自己的心智，不要轻易为他人所动摇。
You mean like you? Like
江湖中人，为了
get out of my house，
借身于朝局之间，为某一方权贵效力，各国并不罕见。可是段同舟已经有了如此高的声望和地位，却仍然不计生死，忠心至此，恐非名利二字所能解释。平静，你觉得他会图什么呢？
谁知道呢？
走吧。怎么了？
这个文秀，我总觉得在哪见过。
Wait a minute, that's the mom. Crown Prince mom, right? Is that him? Or is that her? It's on her, the one that's holding the Crown Prince. Who is she?
娘娘放心，只是寻常小儿风寒，保暖江洋几日就好。
太子好端端的，怎么就染上了风寒？你们都是怎么侍候的？
I'm sorry, I didn't know that I was responsible for your son catching the flu.
请太医赶紧开药吧。
是。
Why would you blame your servants for that?
说到宁王叔，真倒是想起来，这和谈若成，便要联姻。王兄知道，宁王叔当初建议让莱阳侯迎娶北燕郡主，朕当时觉得他的年龄身份全都合适，心下已然允准。可他母亲的事儿一出，这自然是不用想了。王兄觉得这宗室当中还有哪个孩子合适啊？
臣不知。
这又是什么意思？
马正与军务相关，父王自当参演。至于其他和谈内容，陛下应当询问内阁。长林将门之府，按理是不能多言的。
你们倒分得清楚。怎么了？宗室子弟的亲事，朕问一下自己的兄长，怎么了？
He's so easy going, dude.
朕听说平津这孩子最近弄了一身的伤，可不能再放纵了。朕不是命你理迎惠王吗？你陪客的时候把他也带上。
遵旨。
有劳问候。
知道殿下旅途劳乏，前两日不敢打扰，不知今日歇息的如何了？
贵国馆驿安排周到，歇息的不错。长林世子之名，即便在我大燕也是人尽皆知。今日一见，果然俊雅高华，名不虚传。
殿下谬赞了。惠王殿下此来，本应我朝太子相迎，只是东宫殿下尚且年幼，不能亲身相陪，失礼之处，还望海涵。
世子客气了。
啊，这位是舍弟平津。
惠王殿下，
那日金陵城外初见，二公子好身手。这位是敝国瀚海王三公子拓跋宇。
Keep looking at this woman, bro. I think she likes him.
奉陛下之命，已经去皇家驿馆见过北燕那位惠王了。据说，一行人一起游赏了东园，相处得极好。
大哥，你不信吗？我在琅琊阁这么些年，别的没学好，眼力总还是有的。这个成华郡主，内息平缓，下盘极稳，绝不是咱们想象中的深宫弱女。依我看，她就算还不到大嫂的程度，应该也差不多了。
北燕骑射之国，一向尚武成风，有一个身手甚好的郡主，也没你说的那么奇怪。
她打扮成那个样子跟着我们，倒还不如直接穿女装呢。
两国风俗不同，北燕女子的行事甚少拘束，说不定人家打扮成那样，反而是顾及咱们的利益呢。
I guess.
你说
，Is Mandarin's like? Is it like a primary fruit there in China?
我已经全都顺了你的性子。明日开始和谈，如无意外，你便是代驾的郡主。依从大梁的风俗，你最好不要再任性而为了。
还记得我当年13岁时，第一次夺得猎场头名。父王夸我，如若是男儿，当可出马扫平天下。现如今皇室衰微，放任叛军步步做大，先祖铁血之风荡然无存。竟连我也不得不远嫁异国，作为一枚和亲的妻子。
重华，你说这些话是什么意思？这和亲的人选又不是惠王殿下定的。再说出发的时候问过你，你不是说很愿意吗？
放心吧，我仍然愿意。只要想到咱们国中的一团乱局，我就实在是不能更加愿意了。
既然如此，你好好休息吧。
五哥，和谈若成，五哥回邺后便会册封为太子。不知将来的军政大局，你是如何打算的？
怎么突然想起来问这么大一个问题？
虽远嫁异国，但到底心怀故国，自然是盼着五哥能够早日荡平叛军，稳固我大燕江山。
重华，咱们大燕现在的内战之局，并没有你想象的那么简单。如若民生不得起伏，朝政依然朽坏，单单依凭先祖当年的铁血手腕就想平定乱局，那是根本不可能的。
五哥一向见识深远，无人能及。重华也希望你心想事成。
It's a lot to unpack there. Yo, even if I was acting, I'm pretty sure they would have to shoot this scene a couple of times with me. I would be dying. See somebody doing some shit like this.
受白神感召，先我们一步去享受福报了。
Okay, if you say so, buddy.
我们这前天院向来十分打眼，如今又被人盯得很紧。我在城外庄园里的人和物，就交由三位负责。望三位务必要谨慎，行动之前，万不可再有任何闪失。
是， 定不负长尊大人所托。
The sect's leader，
我们养的人怎么样了？
回长尊大人，一切顺利，那个人已有发病先兆了。
这是狼牙山来的信鸽吧？
对，老阁主知道我在京城肯定无聊，所以看到什么奇闻异事或听到什么新巧的消息就会传信给我。来看看最近这江湖上又闹出什么笑话了。
二公子，您先别忙着看别人的笑话，世子爷派我来通知你说老王爷已经先出发了，让你赶紧过去。
宫宴没有这么早，父王是先进宫下棋去了。
二公子还是赶紧过去吧，反正叫你了。
知道了。
惠王殿下，拓跋公子，
只待盟约签订，燕梁便是姻亲之国，说不定日后有缘，平章还能去贵国一游呢。
若说我燕地风光，倒是有许多值得游赏的地方。我也希望有朝一日，国中清贫，可以邀约世子前来做客。
说句交浅言深的话，贵国叛军能在一年之内几乎占领了半壁江山，恐不是报名负恩四字所能解释。我长林虽是武门，但也知道民心所向，绝非历任所能改也。殿下不愿夷为铁血，有志于正本清源，心胸实在是远超他人，平章对此甚为感佩。
But why does it feel like there's so much tension in the air? This girl is just always watching.
Bisha.
Ah. Eh? 怎么这么快时辰就到了？
Bisha， 差不多可以起驾了。
咱这儿还没分出个胜负呢，回头接着下。那走吧。有话就说呀，在朕这儿还忍着。
回陛下，其实也没有什么可说的。
年轻人的心思还用问？陛下还猜不到吗？
嗯，那看来王兄是猜到了。
你看他穿的这身行头，你戍守攻城和高手见招的机会并不多。北燕使团过几天就要走了，你是想让陛下恩准和瀚海界比试比试？
我
说的没错吧？
陛下，臣以为这和谈初定，今日气氛一定不错，若是说给宴会助兴，拓跋羽应该也不会介意的。
真是不明白你们这些武人比来比去有什么意思。好了好了，朕知道了，
多谢陛下。
Let me see that booty, girl. Oh, Lord. Poke it out. Poke it out. I sound so creepy saying that.
陛下。
殿下。
陛下。
Just let it happen, bro. All right, so this episode was it opened my eyes. It was a pretty chill episode, more slice of life, nothing you know. But it did open my eyes to certain things that are going on in the series. The political aspect of this is a little bit more, should I say, I don't want to say dense. It's a lot more about the political aspect of this, of the show. You know what I'm saying? It's just those, the situation between Liang and Northern Yan, right? As they still haven't really showed us who she's supposed to get married to, like, you know, between these negotiations that are happening. And this was basically an episode, that's why I say I don't have much to say about this episode, because there's nothing to really, nothing deeply really happened in the episode for me to really expound on. Really, it's just kind of showing, mostly it was about those dynamics, the aftermath of what happened in episode 15 for the most part. You know, with, you know, Jinping getting hurt, I mean Pingzheng getting hurt. So, you know, just the interactions between some of the characters and stuff like that. But it has opened my eyes to not only be very weary of this grand princess. Is it grand princess or grand empress? The empress, right? I have to keep an eye on these people because they kind of chilled out this episode. I also realized that young prince is watching the priest manor or whatever where he lives. But why is he spying on them? What is he trying to find out? So that's interesting as well. I guess we're gonna see how that develops. I'm gonna keep watching today because I'm curious to see what's gonna be the aftermath of this. Of course, we're probably gonna get that showdown between Faizan and whatever his name is, the other dude that was fighting Duan, whatever. You guys know what I'm talking about, okay? These names be killing me. But in any case, this was awesome, man. This is I'm still gonna keep going, guys. I'm not gonna stop watching the series because it's not as good as Nirvana in Fire. We all know that it's not as good, like that is established. But it's still very interesting to watch a C drama that's kind of chill sometimes, you know what I'm saying? I mean, in Nirvana in Fire, we never had episodes that were like nothing is really happening. It's more slice of life more than anything else. Never had an episode like that in Nirvana in Fire. So this was more of a chill episode, just showing the dynamics between the characters, the aftermath of the last episode and stuff like that. So I'm guessing they're gonna probably jump back into things for episode 17, but we'll see. Anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Leave a like, leave a comment. I will catch you guys later, man. Peace.